And guys, let's see who is asking me the next question. So this is from Aparna, and she's from Bangalore. Hi Aparna, and she wants to know about the additives for paraffin pillar candle. Okay, so Aparna, the additive for paraffin pillar candle is regular stearic acid, and if you want to add viber, you can add viber into it also. Now let me tell you the ratio of adding stearic acid into your paraffin wax. So if you are using fully refined straight paraffin wax, suppose if it is in the quantity of 500 grams, then you have to use 3 tablespoons of stearic acid into it and 1 teaspoon of viber into it. So this is the additive for paraffin wax and for soy container candles. Okay, soy, if you are asking me for soy candle, then it is palm stearic acid for soy candles. Can you please help me with the pillar and container blends of different kinds? Definitely I would like to help you in this topic, but since there are so many kinds of blends we use to create beautiful candle out of it, and it is not easy for me to answer because it is such a long answer. And what I am thinking is I just create a separate video on how to make different blends to create beautiful candles out of it. This will not only help you but to help other people also who loves to create beautiful candles. So stay with me and keep watching my channel, my upcoming videos. One of my upcoming video will be the blends of different kinds of waxes to create beautiful candles. And definitely I would like to give you one answer of a blend that if you want to create beautiful pillar candles, just add 60% of soy wax and 40% of straight paraffin wax, fully refined paraffin wax. It will give you a good strengthened pillar candle. So this is one of the blend, and definitely I'll make another video to show you varieties of blends to create beautiful candles. Thanks for posting me this beautiful question, Aparna, and now it's time to move on to the another question. So this is from Ruby August. Okay, where can I get colors of wax online, like the whole set of different colors? Okay, so basically I purchase it from amazon.in. if you are living out of India, then amazon.com is the best site to purchase all the candle making supplies, because it is a very trustworthy site, because I'm using it since so long, and so I can say this to you. Can you please give a thorough on colors, types and varieties and their pigmentation in depth? Wow Ruby, this is indeed a very 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 beautiful question which you have asked me, and I'm promising you that this topic is in my list, and in my upcoming videos I'll give you the thorough information regarding the pigments of the candles. And so be with me, and definitely one of my upcoming videos will be regarding this topic. Are colors different for different kinds of wax, like for gel, paraffin, beeswax, etc.? Okay, so I'll pick one, that is gel wax. So if you are making candle out of gel wax, then definitely I'll say that use liquid color dyes, and which is very easy to work with gel wax. And the rest I will tell you in my upcoming video on the pigments of candles. So stay with me and keep watching my videos and keep posting your questions to me, Ruby. And once again, thanks for this beautiful question. Hey guys, so this next question is from Yasmin. Hi Yasmin, I would like to know how could I recognize the wick size if it is not mentioned on the packaging. Yes, this is indeed a very difficult for each and everyone to pick the right size of the wick. So as I told earlier, just do one thing, just measure the size of the container or the pillar candle. Suppose if it is 3 inches, if the diameter is 3 inches, just go for 2.5 mm wick or 3 mm wick, and just do an experiment using these two sizes of wick. If you find that the flame is very steady and very smooth after burning for 2 hours continue, then the wick is perfect. If it is throwing black smoke and if it is burning very high, and if it is moving like this, then definitely this is a bigger size and you have to go for a smaller size than this. So this is the practical which you have to do to find the right size wick. Okay, I would like to know how to choose the right wick for the right candle size diameter. This is what I have answered you. Could we use all the wick types with all the different waxes? Well Yasmin, this is quite tricky to answer because there are varieties of candle wicks available in the market, like cotton wick, pepper wick, zinc and wooden wick, and the flat one and the round one and blah blah blah. So it is quite difficult to answer in just one line. But one thing I would like to mention here, that if you are making eco-friendly candles, like if you are making palm wax candle, like soy wax candle or beeswax candle, then go for cotton braided candle, which is flat, and you can also use wooden wick to create beautiful candles. Let's see what is the next question. So the next question is from Sanya Narang. Hi Sanya, and she is asking that when we have uneven texture, once the candles are out of the mold, so how to give finishing touches to it? Wow, that's really I must say that once if you demold your candle and you will find that it is not smooth, it has uneven surface, and it is not really that beautiful candle which you want to create. So once you demold the candle, it is quite difficult to give the finishing touches to it. So better you will keep few things in mind while you pouring the wax into the mold. So the first thing you have to do is preheat your mold. Second thing you have to do is to use a silicone spray, which will help you in demolding your candle in a more smooth way. Third, you have to keep monitoring the temperature of the pouring wax. So if you are making candles, pillar candles with paraffin wax, then the ideal pouring temperature of the wax is 80 degrees centigrade. And once you pour the wax into the mold, do not move your mold from one place to another regularly. Just keep it at that place only where you fill your mold, and once it will get cooled down, then allow it to set for at least 6 to 7 hours or overnight before demolding it. And if you want to post me the pictures, please click onto the link given in the description box. Thanks for asking me this beautiful question. And now it's time for the another question, and this is from Isha Sambre, and she says, hello, hi Isha, I'm from India, I have 4 questions. Wow, 4 questions. Okay Isha, so let's start with the question number 1. So she is asking me that when wax is heated at home, okay, is the smoke dangerous or cancerous for lungs? Well Isha, as you asked me this question, you must have to mention me that which wax you are talking about. So there are varieties of wax. So I cannot answer this question because I need a specific wax to answer here. Second question is, I have made around 40 different designer paraffin wax candles for trial before selling. Wow, congratulations. But when they burn, a lot of wax is wasted. How can that be avoided? Okay Isha, so please check the size of the wick you are using in your candles. Might be possible that the size of the wick is smaller than what is required. Please use one size of wick which you are using right now and see the result. Now the question number 3 is, what should be the purity of paraffin and gel wax, like refined, semi-refined, grade, etc. Okay. So Isha, if you are making candles using paraffin wax, go for fully refined paraffin wax, which is also called as a food grade paraffin wax. It is somehow very less harmful to the health as compared to another grade of paraffin wax. And for gel wax, go for medium grade. And now coming the 4th question from Isha, and she is asking that how can we get a sure market for selling homemade designer candles? So wow Isha, this is again a very beautiful question, and as I promised earlier in this video that I'm going to make a video on how to start candle making business. So this topic will be covered in that video, and which is my upcoming video. So keep watching my videos and you will get all the answers related with this question. So thanks for posting all these beautiful questions Isha to me, and keep watching my videos and keep posting your valuable comments and questions to me. Thank you. So guys, this is it for today, and I'm really very impressed with the quality of the questions you have asked to me. And definitely now what I'm thinking is to keep taking the question answer session related with the candle making queries. And I hope that I did justice to your questions. And if you still find any difficulty in understanding any of the topic, please do write in the comment section, and keep watching my videos and stay with me guys. Take care of yourself. We'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.